For watching on KUM TV and streaming us on YouTube. I cannot believe we are more than halfway through March and we have not done an interview with a Ernest DeChoco play. Fortunately, the man, the myth, the legend is here, as is Veronica Flores.
Hello.
It has been too long for you as well, madam.
I know. I should come over more often.
But you are here in a much different capacity.
I am.
Because now you are showing your proclivity for the stage.
Exactly. It's very exciting. I'm very much looking forward to it.
You are a woman of many, many talents.
Apparently so.
She is. Okay. She is so great. This woman has
well, that's
so
praise
much
from Caesar right yeah. here. Look who's saying.
Amazing performance, everything. This woman has got it all.
Okay, yeah. Well, we're bearing the lead right now because, yeah. of course, Ernest, your latest endeavor is you are bringing Mamma Mia to the stage.
Yes, I am.
Congratulations.
Thank you. It was a long time coming. About my coworkers have been asking for the rights directly from England. From the West End.
That's always the tough part, right?
Yeah.
Getting the rights to a play.
Getting the rights, yeah. And it's about 10 years of them asking for the rights and being in reserve for the last few years.
Does this have anything to do with the fact that Mamma Mia, the movie, is now doing so well? Did that accelerate the process a little bit more?
You know, I'm not sure, but I know after a certain amount of runs on Broadway or the West End, the producers want to make sure that they let it become more accessible. So perhaps after the 20th year, because it's the 20th year anniversary of Mamma Mia, mm-hmm. I think that's when they decided to share it with the rest of the world in more of a larger capacity.
Okay, now yeah. for the 11 people out there that have never seen Mamma Mia and are unfamiliar with it, Veronica,
I think it's 9 people.
Very good. If you would, can you give us a breakdown of the characters and the plot?
So Mamma Mia, it's a really fun musical, of course. It follows the story of a mother and daughter, particularly a mother who has had a lot of fun in her past, and her daughter is getting married at the moment, and she does not know who the father is, and the daughter has invited all the fathers to the wedding.
Without the mom's knowledge.
Exactly.
Without
dun, dun, dun.
I know, yes. Scandal, right? Yeah.
Drama ensues.
Yes, yes. So the daughter invites them over, not just to do that, but in secret and during her wedding. So, and all her friends are there, everyone's there, and all of this drama's occurring. And it's like going to a Guam fiesta.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of drama that happens during
the
fiesta.
There might be one or two gossipy stories there,
exactly.
Right? So it's kind of like that, and it kind of exemplifies exactly how we live sometimes. And it may not be as pretty as what happens in the show, but we definitely live the same types of mm-hmm. stories.
Now, of course, in the movie, which most people I would assume are familiar with. You've got Christine Baranski, you've got this all-star cast mm-hmm. of
yeah,
people.
Meryl Streep.
How could I say Meryl Streep second?
Right.
she normally gets top billing.
Right. But Pierce Brosnan is in it.
Yeah,
too.
Famous people of stage and screen. But undeniably, the star of the play is the music.
Of course.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
ABBA.
Exactly.
And it's
yeah. Swedish
absolutely
royalty.
Amazing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How is it performing that, Veronica?
It is quite amazing. I think growing up, growing up because I was dancing a lot and singing a lot, you do learn Dancing Queen, Waterloo and everything. And to be able to do it now on stage with an amazing cast as well, it's a lot of fun, mm. definitely.
And this is music that resonates with at least 2 generations because
yeah,
even the next
even
generation.
More.
Yeah, I'm an old guy and I remember listening to ABBA when I was a kid. That's how far back it goes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the children that are part of the show, because you know me, I'm always about inclusivity, right?
Mm-hmm.
Getting everybody involved, making sure that it's a community project and making sure that everyone kind of, gets along, right? Unifying the community is so big for me. And all the little children, the parents are telling me that they're getting sick of it because the kids only want to listen to ABBA mm-hmm. in the car. Going to school, coming back from school, yeah. in
it's
the
really
house,
refreshing,
while they're
think.
Doing their homework.
It
yeah, it's really interesting.
I mean, it's uplifting. It's,
yeah.
it's
yeah.
And to see all the young kids so enthusiastic as well, when we go through a lot of our rehearsals, the kids, a lot of the middle schoolers and elementary school kids really get into it as well. And that gives the rest of us a lot of energy as well when we are rehearsing.
What's their favorite number? I would think the
oh
title
my
number.
God.
Oh, there's too many.
Everyone, I think, kind of connects with every single number, but I know one of our biggest numbers is Dancing Queen.
Mm-hmm.
So have you heard of the flash mob that we're doing for the show?
I heard about it. I heard yeah. it's coming up.
So we have another one tomorrow. It's a rehearsal. So we're going to do a flash mob within the show itself. So if you have come to our rehearsal, our flash mob rehearsals, when you come to watch the show, you can participate with the cast during the actual number.
Did you have Sabrina do that?
Yeah, I'm going to ask her to, I'm going to bring her over. I'm going to just
don't say that too loud because if she hears it, she She didn't get an Evite yet.
Did she not?
Okay. No, I'm saying if she hasn't, she's going to come and break up this interview. Oh, and she's gonna, you're going to get a stern lecture, and that's putting it lightly.
So right now we had about 300 people from the community come and join us during the flash mob rehearsals. Our final flash mob is tomorrow at 6 p.m. at Guam Department of Education, the main building in Teedson. So if you Google that, you'll find it.
And it's on Google Maps.
Yeah, it'll show you where to go. Okay. But tomorrow night, 6 p.m., it's only 30 minutes long, and you get to join us on for the stage.
Okay, now, yeah. For people who don't know, is this a period piece? And if so, because, of course, the music of ABBA kind of goes back, you know, you've got that
the
disco
70s,
feel.
Right?
Yeah, it's kind of like encapsulated within the 70s.
Well, it's the 90s for now. It's set in the 90s. And one more thing about the flash mob. If you come and sign up, your name is also included in the program booklet with the rest of the cast.
Nice.
Right?
One
Isn't that so cool? Yeah.
So all you have to do is just show up and have fun, and you get billing in a play?
Yes, you do.
And you have to learn some moves, of course.
Okay, of course.
And it's really easy moves, too, but they're fun moves.
Okay,
really
Veronica, fun. Which character do you play, by the way? I should have asked that.
I am one of the Rosies in the show. So we have Donna as our main lady in the show, and her two friends, Tanya and Rosie.
The Dynamos.
Yes.
What challenges does this present to you as a thespian, and like as opposed to like maybe other roles you've played?
Yeah, I think it really, you know, for me, I'm in my day-to-day life, I'm probably not a jokester and you know, fly by the seam of my pants type of person, but this character Rosie really personifies that, really encompasses a woman of the 70s, very independent and everything like that. So
female empowerment, exactly. The whole nine yards, yeah. With this character.
Exactly.
Yeah,
very
and
nice.
So it's been really, really fun trying to you know, work with the rest of the cast, trying to figure out how everyone else ticks and working off everyone else's energy.
Okay, now Ernest, as far as the costuming goes, because you are someone who takes great pride in your ability to capture an aesthetic,
yes.
Yeah. So you were telling
like
me
this outfit is an aesthetic.
You're telling me something specifically about your ring.
Look at your pinky ring. Not my shirt. One I just picked from the jungle right
okay,
now.
Okay. That's but your ring. I mean, I looked. If you can hold that up, we'll get a shot of that. Your ring. It looks like you're Thanos. It looks like
right
you got
here,
the Infinity Gauntlet on.
I have the Infinity Ring. It's the miniature version of the Infinity Gauntlet. No, I'm kidding.
There you go.
But
please don't snap your fingers.
I know, right? I don't want it to disappear. So this right here encompasses all the colors of all the costumes for every single character in the show.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the this is my focus to remind myself and to kind of get connected with every single character.
Well done. All right. Well, we have to go. But where can people get tickets, and when is opening night?
Oh, you can get tickets at Circle K76 Tango Theaters and Father Duenas Memorial School. We will have them available by next week Monday, which is the 25th. So we will have that ready for the entire world to start purchasing.
All right, well, all hands in.
All hands
all right.
in.
Thank you, guys. Break a leg.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to go to commercial. There you go. We are going to go to commercial break. All the world's a stage, and wonderful people like this are bringing you high-quality entertainment, so make sure to go out and see it. You're going to have a big smile on your face, as you will when we return right after this.